tow truck update. She's getting lots of metal work on her tomorrow. We're putting two brand new sides on it. I'm gonna bring a trailer load over here. Oh, I got some 20 feet pieces. I got four. It's 4-inch by 1/4-inch thick. I'm gonna use those for the new bed rails on the tow truck. Oh, I got four of them down in Moncton. It was $405 taxes in, so that equals out to $101.25 a piece, if I'm correct. I'm not sure. But anyways, like I was saying, we're all, lad's coming tomorrow. He got a mobile welding truck. He's going to take the torches and cut the sides off. And we're going to bring the angle iron down like this, so it's going to rest on the bed. Well, imagine side 8 there. Rest on the bed and come down, and then I'll mount my lights in it. And then I'll bring another piece and mount it on top and bolt that piece on and not weld it on, so I could take it off if I got to move sea cans or baby barns. And then this is 1/4-inch and then 3/8 underneath it. And then there's going to be 1/4-inch and 1/4-inch, so that should stiffen up the bed. I'm going to stop it from tilting here in the middle. This bottom piece kicks out when you put it on the ground. I'm going to get rid of that, make it one solid piece, and then we're going to weld a strip up the middle just to stiffen it all up. And then, because I don't like it tilting. When I got a car on the back and I have a chain down, like imagine the rear axles right here. When I got the chain coming to, like, for example, the rear axle on a truck, when I hit a real bad bump on the road, the bottom of the bed will actually slap up and it'll loosen the chain and let the truck kick either way. So I'm fucking going to get rid of that. Because it's, I don't know, I don't like it. It doesn't make me comfortable. So I'll get rid of it and I'll make the bed one solid piece like most tow trucks. And as you can see, I got like a rib down there I got to change. And that's about it. The rest of the ribs are good. Oh, there's one rib up here with a little pinhole. This one right here. But the rest of them are good. I was pressure washing the frame, taking all the scaly stuff off, and then I can clean it up real quick. It's easier just to pressure wash the scale off. This is all original paint for the most part. It's pretty good for an Eastern Canada truck. All the salt roads. And then, I'll paint the frame up and I'll paint the sides and make her all pretty again. Get her ready to work. But yeah, this pig here, it did pretty good today. Probably put, I'm gonna say 280 to 300 kilometers on today. It fared pretty good. It only caught, it burned about, I'm gonna say 40, or no, I'm lying, 62 liters. Because gas is way down, so I'm just gonna say liters, 60 liters in gas. So it ain't terrible. That's driving 60 mile an hour, 70 mile an hour all day on 38-inch tires with the V10, so I can't complain. And I gotta take this off and give Buddy back his trailer because I kind of stole it on today, because I didn't want to take tow truck down to Moncton. This is way faster than taking the tow truck. But I pretty much shut the tow truck down until hopefully I have it done tomorrow, and then I can start working it again Friday. But you gotta shut it down sometimes to do maintenance. It's the only way around it. And there's a new brood force in all her glory. But that's pretty much it for today.